The U.S. Army's new precision strike missile, PrSM, short-range ballistic missile, has successfully been used against a moving target at sea for the first time as part of Valiant Shield 24. On June 16th, two PrSM missiles were launched during SINKEX from the Army's Autonomous Multi-Domain Launcher, AML, in Palau, Micronesia. This marked the first time that the PrSM and AML were deployed outside the United States, according to the Army. The systems were operated by the Army's 3rd Multi-Domain Task Force, 3MDTF, and the 1-181 Artillery Regiment of the Tennessee National Guard. Valiant Shield 24 is a multinational field training exercise held from June 7th to 18th that took place in Guam, the Commonwealth of the Northern Mariana Islands, Palau, and the surrounding sea of the Mariana Island Range Complex. According to the U.S. Navy, the exercise focused on integrating interoperability in a multi-domain environment, with joint forces collaborating to detect, locate, track, and engage units at sea. The target for the SINKEX maneuvers was the decommissioned Austin-class amphibious transport dock ex-USS Cleveland LPD-7, positioned in the North Pacific Ocean about 75 kilometers or 45 miles from the nearest land. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what is the implication of PrSM hitting a moving ship in Valiant Shield 24. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. PrSM, being developed by Lockheed Martin, is a priority program and is intended to replace the Army Tactical Missile System, or Army TACMS. Army Tactical Missile System is a surface-to-surface missile also manufactured by Lockheed Martin. The Army TACMS can be fired from the M270 Multiple Launch Rocket System, MLRS, and M142 High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, HIMARS. The first use of the Army TACMS in a combat capability was during the Persian Gulf War's Operation Desert Storm, where a total of 32 were fired from the M270 MLRS. Several of these have also been provided to Ukraine and have yielded impressive results. The limited range of 190 miles or 300 kilometers has paved the way for the development of PrSM. While the PrSM development program started out as a competitive effort between Lockheed and Raytheon Technologies, the latter left the competition early in 2020. Similar to Army TACMS, PrSM will be compatible with M270, MLRS, and HIMARS. Since PrSM has a ballistic trajectory and greater speed, it will be hard to intercept when compared to cruise missiles like Tomahawk. The original intent for PrSM was to reach a maximum of 499 kilometers, or 310 miles, but America's 2019 withdrawal from the Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces, or INF, treaty with Russia has allowed the U.S. Army to develop the missile with greater range. INF treaty was signed by Ronald Reagan and Mikhail Gorbachev in 1987. It banned ground launch missiles with ranges from 500 kilometers to 5,500 kilometers, that's 310 to 3,420 miles. The INF treaty eliminated around 2,700 nuclear and conventional missiles, as well as their launchers. This was achieved in May 1991. This included short-range missiles with 310 to 620 miles, or 500 to 1,000 kilometers range, and intermediate-range missiles with 620 to 3,420 miles, or 1,000 to 5,500 kilometers range. The treaty had provisions for 10 years of on-site inspections. INF treaty went a long way in ending the serious standoff between U.S. Pershing and cruise missiles and Soviet SS-20 missiles in Europe. PrSM Increment 1 is meant for surface-to-surface warfare and was being designed to take on targets such as air defenses and troop fortifications. Increment 2, with a multi-mode seeker, known as the Land-Based Anti-Ship Missile, LBASM seeker, is able to engage moving targets, including rivals' surface combatants, in seas. Hitting a moving target at sea from land is exceptionally challenging. For instance, during a 2023 live fire exercise off the coast of a Philippine training facility near Subic Bay, the Army's HIMARS rockets missed a ship. The Army pinpointed targeting difficulties as the munition struggled to account for drift. At sea, drift poses a complex problem since ships can move 30 to 40 meters in the time it takes to lock onto a target and fire ammunition. PrSM Increment 3 would add in enhanced lethality payloads. Increment 4 aims to achieve a flight range exceeding 1,000 kilometers or 620 miles, potentially doubling the range of the current version. The service has already enlisted both a Lockheed Martin team and a team comprised of Raytheon Technologies and Northrop Grumman to collaborate on competing designs for this increment. PrSM is a much-needed weapon for the U.S. military, especially since the geostrategic situation changed for the worse in the last 2 to 3 years. Russia was in violation of the INF Treaty and has already manufactured missiles like the Novator 9M729. Chinese Rocket Forces has more than 2,000 ballistic and cruise missiles, almost 95% of which would violate the INF Treaty if China were a signatory. PrSM will place the U.S. military on a level playing field. The missile placed in Europe will be able to threaten Russian strategic and tactical assets. Similarly, the missile, if made available to Taiwan and Japan, will be a strong counter to China. Importantly, the missile could be used to take on Russian and Chinese warships, which are increasing in number and also improving in quality. The particular engagement in Valiant Shield 24 utilized high-altitude balloons fitted with electromagnetic spectrum sensors and radio networking equipment, alongside an ultra-long-endurance aerial drone, all integral to the kill chain. This scenario exemplifies the distributed sensor and shooter network the U.S. Army has been developing for years, especially relevant in the Pacific theater. Overall, it can be interpreted that PrSM can add a lot of flexibility to American forces. The service aims to achieve initial operational capability with the system sometime this year. The Army received its first operational PrSMs late last year.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.